is our God, and always and ever, and to ages of ages.
Amen. Glory to thee, our God, and glory to thee, our heavenly King, counselors, liars, and kings, for every of our presence and fill us all things, treasury of good things and giver of life. Come and dwell in us and cleanse us of all impurity, and save our souls from good wrong. God, we mighty, holy, merciful, have mercy on us. God, we mighty, Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on them. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and in the ages of ages. Amen. O most Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and forever.
Amen. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and into the ages of ages. Amen. O come, let us worship God our King. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and God. Hearken, O Lord, unto my righteousness, attend unto my supplication. Give ear unto my prayer, which cometh not from the seat of the lips. From before thy face, let my judgment come forth. Let mine eyes behold uprightness. Thou hast proved my heart, and thou hast visited it in the night. Thou hast tried me by fire, and then righteousness was not found in me. Let my mouth might not speak the words of men. For the sake of the words of thy lips have I kept away, set our heart. Set my footsteps in thy paths, that my steps may not be shaken. I cry, for thou hast hearkened unto me, O God. Incline thine ear unto me, and hearken unto my words. Let thy mercies be made wonderful, O thou that savest and that hope in thee. From them that are resisted thy right hand, give me, O Lord, of the apple of thine own. And shelter thy
people,
O thou shelter me from the face of the ungodly which have oppressed me. My enemies have surrounded my soul, they have enclosed themselves with their own fat, their mouth has spoken pride. They that cast me up and down encircled me, they have set their eyes to look askance on the earth. They have taken me as my delight, ready for his prey, and as my delight dwelleth in hiding. Arise, O Lord, overtake them and trip their heels. Deliver my soul from ungodly men, thy sword from the enemies of thy hand. O Lord, from thy few do thou separate them from the earth and their life. Yea, with the hated treasures hath their belly them filled. They have satisfied themselves with swine and left the remnants to their babes. But as for me, in righteousness shall I appear before thy face. I shall be filled when thy glory is made manifest to me. Unto thee, O Lord, have I lifted up my soul. O my God, in thee have I trusted. Let me never be put to shame, nor let mine enemies laugh me to scorn. Yea, let none that wait on thee be put to shame. Let them be ashamed which are lawless without a cause. Make thy ways, O Lord, known unto me, and teach me thy paths. Lead me in thy truth, and teach me, but our God, my Savior. For on thee have I waited all the day long. Remember thy compassions, O Lord, and thy mercies, for they are from everlasting. The sins of my youth and my ignorances remember not. According to thy mercy, remember thou me for the sake of thy goodness, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord, and therefore will he set a law for them that sin in the way. He will guide the meek in judgment, he will teach the meek his way. All the ways of the Lord are mercy and truth unto them that seek after his covenant and his testimony. For the sake of thy name, O Lord, be gracious unto my sin, for it is great. Who is the man that feareth the Lord? He will set him a law in the way which he hath chosen. His soul shall dwell among good things, and his seed shall inherit the earth. The Lord is the strength of them that fear him, and his covenant shall be manifested unto them. Mine eyes are ever toward the Lord, for he it is that will draw my feet out of the snare. Look upon me, and have mercy on me, for I am one only begotten and poor. The afflictions of my heart are multiplied, bring me out from my necessity. Behold my lowliness and my toil, and forgive all my sins. Look upon mine enemies, for they are multiplied, and with an unjust hatred have they hated me. Keep my soul and rescue me, let me not be put to shame, for I have hoped in thee. The innocent and the upright have believed unto me, for I have waited on thee, O Lord. Redeem Israel, O God, out of all this affliction. mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy compassions, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know mine iniquity, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned and done this evil before thee, that thou mightest be justified in thy words and prevail when thou art just. For behold, I was conceived in iniquity, and in sin did my mother bear. For behold, thou hast loved truth, and hidden in the secret things of thy wisdom hast thou made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me to hear joy and gladness. The bones that be humbled, they shall rejoice. Turn thy face away from my sins, and blot out all mine iniquity. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, with thy governing spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, the ungodly shall turn back unto thee. Deliver me from thy guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation, my tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For thou hast desired sacrifice, thy given is with whole burnt offerings, thou shalt not be clean. The sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit, a heart that is broken and humble, God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, and thy good pleasure and design, let the walls of Jerusalem be builded. Then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer bullocks upon thine altar. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. The angelic powers were at thy tomb, the guards became as dead men. Mary stood by thy grave, seeking thy most pure body. Thou didst capture hell, not being tempted by it. Thou didst come from the virgin, breath and life. O Lord, didst rise from the dead, and glory to thee. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Having our goodness and maintaining continence in all things, thou wast arrayed with a good conscience as befits a priest. From the chosen vessel, let us draw ineffable mystery. Thou dost keep the faith, and dost finish a course equal to his. Hire a martyr, Dionysius. Entreat Christ God that our souls may be saved. For now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Theotokos, thou art the true vine that blossomed forth for us the fruit of life. Thee do we supplicate, and intercede, O Lady, together with the holy apostles, that our souls find mercy. Blessed is the Lord God, blessed is the Lord today by day. The God of our salvation shall prosper us along the way. Our God is the God of salvation. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us, O Lord, blot out our sins, O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Thine is the
kingdom,
the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now ever and forever.
Amen. And Christ God, the giver of life, raised all of the dead from the valleys of misery with his mighty hand. He bestowed resurrection on the human race. He is the Savior of all, the resurrection of life, and the God of all. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Thou at all times and every hour in heaven and on earth have worshipped and glorified, O Christ God, who long suffering, plenteous in mercy, most compassionate, who loves the righteousness, mercy on sinners, who called us all to salvation, to the promise of good things to come. Receive, O Lord, our prayers at this hour, and guide our life for thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, make chaste our bodies, correct our thoughts, purify our intentions, and deliver us from every sorrow, evil, and pain. Compass us about thy holy angels that guarded and guided by their array. We maintain for the unity of faith and the knowledge of thine unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou to the ages of ages. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, and beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim. Without corruption, gave us birth to God the Lord, the very dead, the Holy Ghost, that he be magnified. In the name of the Lord, Father,
our Lord Jesus, the Holy Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us.
Amen. O Master God and Father, almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son of Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, one God, that one power. Have mercy on me, a sinner, and by the judgment which thou knowest. Save me, thou unworthy servant, for blessed art thou unto the ages of the ages. Amen. Come, let us worship God our King. Oh, come, let us worship and fall down before Christ our King and God. Oh, come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and God. O God, in thy name, save me in thy strength, do thou judge me. O God, hearken unto my prayer, give ear unto the words of my mouth. For strangers have risen up against me, and mighty men have fled after my soul, and have not set God before himself. For behold, God helpeth me, and the Lord is protector of my soul. He will bring evils upon my enemies, utterly destroy them by thy truth. Willingly shall they sacrifice unto thee, O confess thy name, O Lord, for it is good. For out of every affliction thou delivered me, and mine eye hath looked down upon mine enemy. Give ear, O God, unto my prayer, and sustain not my supplication. Attend unto me and hear me. I was grieved in my meditation, and I was troubled at the voice of the enemy and at the oppression of the sinner. Because they have turned iniquity upon me, and wrathfully angry against me. My heart is troubled within me, and the terror of death has fallen upon me. Fear and trembling have come upon me, and darkness hath covered me. And I said, who will give me wings like a dove, and I will fly and be at rest? Lo, I have fled afar off, and dwelt in the wilderness. I waited for God to save me from pain, hardness, and from tempest. Plunge them into the depths, O Lord, and divide their tongues, for I have seen iniquity and gainsaying in the city. Day and night they go round about her upon her walls, iniquity and toil and unrighteousness are in the midst of her, and usury and deceit have not departed from her streets. For if mine enemy had reviled me, I might have endured it. And if he that hated me had spoken boastful words against me, I might have hid myself from him. But thou it was, O man of like soul with me, my guide and my familiar friend, and thou together with me to speech my repast. In the house of God I walked with thee enormously mine. Let death come upon such ones, and let them go down the ladder to me. For wickedness is in their dwellings, and in the midst of them. As for me, unto God I cried, and the Lord hearkened unto me. Evening, morning, and noonday will I tell of it, and will declare it, and he will hear my voice. He will redeem my soul in peace from them that draw nigh unto me. Today among men you were with me. God will hear, and he will humble them, he that is before the ages. For to them there is no requital, because they have not feared God. He has stretched forth his hand in retribution. They have defiled his covenant, they were scattered by the wrath of his countenance, and their hearts have been beaten. Their words were smoother than oil, and yet they are darts. Cast thy hair upon the Lord, and he will nourish thee. He will never permit the righteous to be shaven. But thou, O God, shalt bring those men down to the pit of destruction. Bloody and deceitful men shall not live out half their day. But as for me, O Lord, I will hope in thee. He that dwelleth in the help of the Most High shall abide in the shelter of the God of heaven. He shall say unto the Lord, thou art my helper and my refuge. He is my God, and I will hope in him. He shall deliver thee from the snare of the hunters and from every troubling word. Shoulders will he overshadow thee, and under his wings shalt thou hope. For the shield of the truth encompass thee. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the thing that walketh in the darkness, nor for the mishap and the demon of doomday. A thousand shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but unto thee shall they not come nigh. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold, and thou shalt see the reward of sinners. Thou, O Lord, art my hope, thou madest the Most High thy refuge. The evil shall draw nigh thee, and the spirit shall draw nigh unto thy body. Shall the angels charge over thee, and keep thee in all thy ways. On their hands shall they bear thee up, lest at any time thou shalt dash thy foot against the stone. Upon the ass and the basilisk shalt thou tread, and thou shalt trample upon the lion and dragon. He says, hope on me, and I will deliver him. I will shelter him, because he hath known my name. He shall cry unto me, and I will hearken unto him. I am with him in affliction, and I will rescue him and glorify him. Length of days will I satisfy him, and I will show him my salvation. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Your telling powers were at thy tomb, and the guards became as dead men. Mary stood by thy grave, seeking thy most pure body. Let us capture hell, not being tempted by it. Let us come to the Virgin, granting life. O Lord, and just rise from the dead, glory to thee. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Having learned goodness and maintaining continence in all things, thou wast arrayed with a good conscience as befits a priest. From the chosen vessel, let us draw ineffable mysteries. Let us keep the faith and this ministry course equal to his. I remark of Dionysius, entreat Christ God that our souls may be saved, both now and ever and unto the ages of the ages. Amen. Seeing that we have no boldness on account of our many sins, do thou beseech him that was born of thee, O Virgin Dev, O Rules, the supplication of a mother availeth much to an apostle's favor. Stain not the prayers of sinners, O all pure one, her merciful and mighty
mercies,
who deign also to suffer for our sin. Let thy compassions quickly go before us, O Lord, for we are become exceedingly poor. Help us, O God, our Savior, for the sake of the glory of thy name. O Lord, deliver us, and be gracious unto our sins, for thy name's sake. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us, O Lord God, have our sins, O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and in the ages of ages.
Amen. Christ God, the giver of life, raised all the dead from the valleys of misery with his mighty hand. He is the resurrection of the human race. He is the Savior of all, the resurrection of life, and the God of all. Lord, mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Now in all time, every hour, in heaven and on earth, our prayers should be glorified. O Christ, God, with long suffering, bless us in mercy, most compassionate. He loves us the righteousness, mercy on sinners. And call us all to salvation through the promise of good things to come. Receive, O Lord, our prayers at this hour, and guide our life toward thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, may taste our bodies, correct our thoughts, purify our intentions, and deliver us from every sorrow, evil, and pain. Encompass us with thy holy angels, and guarded and guided by their array. We may attain to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of thy unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou in the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. For honorable and cherubim and beyond comparable glories and seraphim, who without corruption gave us birth to God the Word, the very dead told us, and he was magnified. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us.
Amen. O God, and Lord of hosts, and maker of all creation, who by the tender compassion of thy mercy, which transcendeth comprehension, did send down thy only begotten Son, our Lord, and Jesus Christ, for the salvation of our race, and by his precious cross, his tear us under the handwriting of our sins, and thereby his triumph over principalities and powers of darkness. Do thou thyself, O Master, lover of mankind, accept also from us sinners of these prayers of thanksgiving and entreaty, and deliver us from every destructive and dark transgression, and from all enemies, both visible and invisible, that seek to do us evil. Nail down our flesh with the fear of thee, and incline not our hearts unto words or thoughts of evil. But pierce our souls with longing for thee, so that ever looking to thee and being guided by thy light as we behold thee, the unapproachable and everlasting light, we may send up unceasing praise and thanksgiving unto thee, the unoriginate Father, with thine only begotten Son, and thine all holy good and life creating Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Bless Master.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and to ages of ages.
Amen. In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above, for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. Churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who have faith, reverence, and the fear of God, and for here men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Metropolitan Deacon, our Archbishop Benjamin, for the Honorable Presbytery, the Diaconate of Christ, and for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this God-protected land, its president, also authorities, and for those who serve in our forces, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and country, and for those who in faith dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Favorable weather for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by land, by sea, and by air, for the sick and suffering, for captives and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
How we bring our troubles to all the most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints. Let us commit ourselves and each other in all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
Unto thee unto all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
those prayed to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Always remember us, most holy, most pure, most blessed, the glorious Lady, there from us, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and each other and all our lives unto Christ.
now and ever.
O Lord, save the pious.
Spirit,
wisdom,
brook human honors in the sixth home. O Lord, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. To thee, O Lord, will I call. My God, be not silent to me. Save thy people.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the second epistle of the Holy Apostle Paul to the Corinthians.
Let us attend.
Brethren, it is God who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, who has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellence of the power may be of God and not of us. We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted but not forsaken, struck down but not destroyed, always bearing in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that may the life of Jesus also made manifest in our body. For we which live are always delivered unto death, for which Jesus is sake, that the life of Jesus also might be made manifest in our mortal flesh. So then, death is working in us, but life in you. And since we have the same spirit of faith, according to what is written, I have believed and therefore I have spoken. We also believe and therefore speak, knowing that he who raised up the Lord Jesus will also raise us up with Jesus and will present us with you. For all things are for your sakes, that grace having spread through the thanksgiving of many may abound to the glory of God. And to your spirit,
wisdom,
in the sixth song, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
In our midst. Today's reading, as we know, is part of the Sermon on the Mount. And prior to our Lord giving us this great commandment, not only to love, but to love the enemy, to love the person who is, how shall we say it, giving us a hard time, to love the person who is sometimes very aggressive in destructive behavior, it seems almost impossible for us to do. And yet that's what we're called upon to do. And I don't want to pretend let's not let each other off the hook on this one, okay, today? Let us go forth and find out what God is expecting of us and how we can, in fact, do it. If you look through our Lord's Sermon on the Mount, what you really find is Christ's interpretation of the law, of the Old Testamental law. And of course, we know also that Jesus, really, when you come right down to it, is the content of that law. He is the fulfiller of that law. He shows us how we should be. If you want to know how to live according to the law of God, then live as Christ lived. Think as Christ thought. Act as Christ would have us act. We need to have, as they say, that scriptural mind, that understanding of the world through the prism of the gospel. Another way of putting it is when I was listening to a kind of a teaching on the way to Calistoga yesterday, we run around with a kind of veil over our minds and mouths and hearts and everything. And that veil kind of keeps us pretty much in the world. The rewards of the world, the way we should expect to act in the world. And as we take that veil off and understand the depth of what our Lord is teaching us, we begin to live truly and think truly as Christians. And oh, what a burden that takes away. You know, even if for a short period of time, we can remove that veil of ignorance that we live under. And I do mean ignorance. And it's the ignorance of not understanding, finally, the power of God to transform everything in our lives. To transform everything. But we have all sorts of conditions, you know, for that transformation to occur. My problems are different than yours. I have a unique set of circumstances. Well, guess what? Sin's a pretty old thing, like Bishop Callistus likes to say. You know, I told you the story before when somebody came to him who had heard lots of confessions that evening, a priest, and said, "Isn't it interesting that there are no new sins?" Okay? It's the same. It's the same old thing. And so we really work very hard to keep that veil somehow affixed to our minds and to our hearts. And yet if you listen to the way our Lord interprets the law, it's clear that He shows us a path. He says, "You are the salt of the earth." Okay, in other words, we are the ones who are called upon to take care of God's creation. There are lots of people roaming around the earth, but we are the salt of the earth. He expects of us, in a sense, to take responsibility for creation, not to wall ourselves off. And sometimes it feels that way. You know, I'm driving down Jackson Road, you know, and I go, "Ah, there it is, you know. There it is, the sort of place I can sequester myself." There are those moments, I have to confess. But nevertheless, we are supposed to go boldly forth and be, in fact, the salt of the earth. Salt does what? It enlivens things. It preserves. It preserves that which God has given us. We are here to preserve the holy tradition in this very church that we worship in today. And that's why we say, you know, especially during the Divine Liturgy, when the priest raises up the gifts, what does he say? "Thine own of thine own, we offer unto thee, on behalf of all the world, on behalf of all and for all." So we take responsibility for creation. We are also the light of the world. You know, I always liked during the hierarchical liturgy when the bishop was here a couple of weeks ago, just after he does his entrance prayers, the deacon will say, "Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and give glory to God." All of this is what is important in the way we prepare for this next commandment, and that is, learn to love your enemy. At this point, I want to go back and read over the gospel reading again. Can I do that for you? Can you put up with that again? Okay. If you can't, don't raise your hand. Just sit there in a kind of angry, not very nice. So So this is what our Lord teaches. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. These are powerful words. It's the golden rule, isn't it? Really. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. If you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners love those who love them. If you do good to those who do good to you, what credit is that? For even sinners do the same. If you lend to those from whom you hope to receive, what credit is that to you? For even sinners lend to sinners to receive as much again. But love your enemies. Do good and lend, expecting nothing in return. Your reward then will be great, and you will be young, and you will be children of the Most High. For he is kind to the ungrateful and the wicked. Be merciful, just as your Father is merciful. Do not judge, and you will not be judged. And further on in this reading, in the Gospel of Luke, you know, the reminder that all things that are impossible with men are possible with God. So I thought about this quite a bit. What's the best way I can kind of explain this today? And what I ultimately did was to come around to a struggle that I'm having right now. Can I share this one with you? Don't worry, none of you are part of the struggle. You're my joy, all of you. But I guess it was a good number of months ago, I contracted out some work to be done at our place, and wrote out a check, a sizable check, you know, in advance for the work to be done. And months passed, weeks passed, and guess what's happened?
Nothing.
I struggle with this, because on the one hand, who wants to get ripped off, right? Yeah. And what, you know, who do you think I am, actually, you know? Do you think you're going to get, you know, that kind of, that, and you think like that over and over again, what happens? It just starts to tear you up. On the other hand, what is the right way to understand such things? First of all, we have to come back to the basic understanding of what it means to be a Christian, and that is the understanding that all things are in God's hands. All things are in God's hands. And therefore, to rail against such things in a way can be very unproductive. Forgive those, as our Lord says in the Lord's Prayer, and we forgive those who trespass against us. Okay. If we don't do that, if we don't learn to work on that, and the way we do that is to again remind ourselves that, okay, place this in God's hands. Don't place it in your own hands. You know, because if you do that, you're going to spend hours. Maybe you go to court, maybe you do all these sorts of things, but you'll spend hours and hours just wearing yourself out. Thou hast prepared, as it says in the Psalm, thou hast prepared a place for me in the presence of mine enemies. You know, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Thou hast prepared a place for me in the presence of mine enemies, a table for me, so to speak. So what that means, I think, in effect, is that even though all of these things may be going on around us, and people may be taking advantage of us one way or the other, our place, our proper place, is to sit at the table of the Lord, and in this case, especially the Eucharistic table. And as I was thinking about this, usually it's in the car when I'm driving along, as I was thinking about this more and more, I realized, my goodness, you know, you've been given the church, you've been given the body of Christ, you've been given the body and blood of Christ, you've been given brothers and sisters in the church, you've been given a wonderful home and a family to be with, you've been given all these things, and here you are, kind of, you know, moping around, worrying about your measly check, you know. And it became a little more clear to me, you know, where our priorities have to rest. But does this make sense, brothers and sisters? We must learn to do this. And these thoughts come after us again and again. The devil tries to get to us this way. But over and over again. Over and over again. So, the ability, therefore, to forgive is very much at the heart of this. And remember again what our Lord teaches us in this reading. He allows the sun to shine on the wicked and the ungrateful, just as he does on those who are grateful unto him. You know. So if God can show such mercy, certainly we have to show such mercy too. It's the safe way. It's the good way. Okay, it's the right way. It doesn't mean that you can't point things out to people at times, but it does mean that we don't harbor a deep resentment that goes on and on and on. And probably to some degree it's good for us. To some degree, the obstacle in front of us, the enemy, the person who makes life difficult for us, gives us sort of the courage to try even harder, to undergo even more trials and temptations. All right? So that's the story today. So we all going to do this? Christ is in our hearts.
Faithful, praying for the Lord may have mercy on them.
most blessed Tikhon, Archbishop of Washington, D.C., and Metropolitan of all America and Canada, may the Lord our God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and to ages of ages. The most reverend Benjamin, Archbishop of San Francisco in the West, may the Lord our God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
All those in priests and monastic orders, may the Lord God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and into the ages of ages. The President of the United States, all those in civil authority, those who serve in the armed forces in these times of peril, may the Lord God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
All those who depart this life of faith and hope of the resurrection, may the Lord God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. All those Christians suffering persecution in the face throughout the world, may the Lord God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. For all those who are sick and suffering, those in hospitals, nursing homes, institutions, Archbishop Andrew, recovering the church, the Lord God remember his kingdom, always, now and ever, unto ages and ages. For the founders and benefactors of this holy house, those who labor, and those who sing, and those who serve, for all those whom we have in our hearts, the Lord God remember his kingdom, always, now and ever, unto ages of ages. You, the Lord of the Christians, the Lord God remember his kingdom, always, now and ever, unto ages of ages.
Thank you. shall come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, to give her a blood who proceeds from the Father, with the Father and the Son together, is worshipped and glorified and spoke by the
for you and for many, for the remission of sin. Let us ask of the Lord.
before the fearful judgment seat of Christ. Let us ask.
Grant this, O Lord.
Having asked for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other in all our life, and through Christ our God.
Forgive us.
Orthodox Christian, we should prepare them with prayer, fasting, and regular practice of confession. We have three chalices today.
Thank you.
mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks to the Lord.
Thank you.
names these anniversaries this week, and then we'll dismiss the crucial teachers and students, and then we'll sit down for announcements. Yeah. Father Deacon.
Okay, on the floor is Horace Groves' birthday, Elizabeth Robertson's birthday, Lizzie, and Kyprian Robertson's birthday. On the 6th, Gabriel Reed's birthday, Father Tom's Names Day, and Ben Giesbach's Names Day and birthday, Ben Thomas. On the 7th, Cheryl Gabbard's birthday. On the 8th, Jack Reed's birthday, Monishka Vicky Plefka's birthday, Lauren Johnson's birthday, Mary Johnson's birthday, and Luke Wagner's birthday. Then on the 9th, Sally Lottie's Names Day, and Gregory Zagralin's birthday, and that's what I have.
Brian's birthday is on Saturday.
Right. Okay. All right.
Grant, O Lord, a peaceful life, health, salvation, visitation, and furtherance of all good things to thy servants, Horace, Lizzie, Kyprian, Gabriel, Father Tom, Ben Thomas, Cheryl, Jack, Monishka, Vicky, Lauren, Mary, Ruth, Sally, Gregory, Brian, and grant them many years.
Next Saturday will be our Wine Stroll fundraiser that you've been hearing about. Again, this is one of our biggest fundraiser events for our building program. A pleasant evening to you. I'm jumping ahead. Thank you. We're getting ahead of ourselves. So actually 2 weeks, lots of time. So again, the note, you can buy your tickets online or from Claudia in person. Do we have the ones who have taken tickets? Need them back?
Yes, if you've taken tickets, I need any unsold or sold tickets and money by next Sunday the 10th. And also, Sarah was organizing the raffle, but she had to leave town, so I'm doing it. So anybody that promised raffle prizes, please make sure I have them by next Sunday as well.
Thank you.
I wanted to add to that if anybody wants anything wrapped, like a gift basket, you can bring it to me. and I will wrap it up. Just provide the basket with your items, and I'll take care of the wrap of the tissue, and then I'll give it back here to church.
And if anybody knows what happened to the sign on the corner of Jackson and Watt, it's missing. So I don't know if anybody knows anything about that.
Yeah,
okay. I just
want to
make sure no one here has it or something.
Unfortunately, well, and again, so that's on the 16th, not this Saturday. I'm getting ahead of myself. And again, I mentioned if there were any college students that were 21 or older, or others who are not working right now, but would like to come and help with cleanup or something, we have some donated, we get a donated ticket for you to attend. So just see me if you would like to do that. Other announcements, St. John's Monastery mentions need of some assistance completing their fire prevention projects, I think particularly related to deck, something with the deck, but otherwise could certainly use a work day retreat, so if you're interested in getting a group together to go up, please let me know. So next Saturday, we're actually having a retreat. It's a retreat on, well, remote, I think it's through Facebook or Zoom for Holy Assumption Monastery, that Father Ian and I will be leading it from 10 a.m. to noon on the Orthodox understanding of illness and healing. Father Ian, did you want to say anything about this, Father Ian? Well, I guess I don't see him, but I will say.
There he is.
Would you like to say anything about the retreat next Saturday?
Come and join us if you can. And come and join us.
It's something, well, the topic is something from a wonderful little book called The Theology of Illness that we'll be using as kind of the basis of it. But there's been a lot talked about, of course, in the last couple of years, understandably. But to put some of this in perspective, where does sickness come from? How do we approach it? How do we understand Orthodox Christians? How do we kind of, process this and deal with the struggle in our own life or for others, and hopefully we can give a little perspective, I think, to reflect upon for that retreat. Today we have, as I mentioned, church school right now, the adult class will be meeting today here in the church when you hear the bell ring. And the 30 continuing Old Testament survey. Tomorrow morning we have a food program. Wednesday we'll have Vespers in our Orthodox Faith and Life class. We're nearing the end of our study of the Creed right now. We mentioned the retreat on Saturday, and then the normal schedule for Vespers and Liturgy next weekend. Wine Stroll on the 16th, and on the 31st, I'll also make mention of, remember in the Western Church calendar, it used to, the 31st was the eve of All Saints Day, and we had something a little bit different to invite Baba Kothis to All Saints in North America at 6 p.m. with some activities. Montes Gajoni and Rachel, did you want to say anything, what you have planned for that evening?
Yeah, so come, bring your kids. The kids are invited to dress up as a saint. Well, we're dwelling at the All Saints Fair. We'll start off with the Kothis to All Saints of North America, and then we'll have pizza for people, and then games, like a saint scavenger hunt, and then a game what we like to call Father Bless for the kids. So hopefully it'll be an educational time for the kids to teach them more about the saints, and hopefully they'll come dressed as one of their beloved saints. If anyone who is planning on coming could please just kind of tell me so I can kind of think about how much pizza to get, how much things to have available, that would definitely be helpful, but log that on your calendars.
Thank you.
And there will be candy.
John.
Father, one more thing on the wine stroll. The sign-up list is on the table in the back. Do you have the table up today? Anyway, we have one sign-up list here today. And one thing I just wanted to suggest is, some of us can give a lot, contribute a lot financially throughout the year to the building of this church that we're trying to build. But this is an opportunity for those of us that don't have that means. We can contribute time, and it does help build this church. So consider that. Thank you.
Yes, thanks. So,
there's lots of empty spaces.
Thank you for mentioning that. I would neglect to say volunteers are still needed for a number of different areas. And just say please. But if you can't make it yourself, you can buy a ticket and invite a friend or relative, and you can give them a gift of one. So, all right. then we will have a post-communion. A wonderful day, everyone. May the blessing of the Lord be upon you. Glory to thee, O God. Glory to thee, O God. Glory to thee, O God.